Hello viewers, so welcome again to my server video tutorial. In my last video tutorial, I have shown you that how to create a partition and how to mount that partition. But it is not permanent mount. If we reboot our machine, we will not get that mounted partition space. Now I will update my mount for this. Right and O into mount space hyphen A. Enter. Now I'll show my hard disk and my drive to see drive right df space hyphen H. Then press enter. Yeah. Here you can see that my drive SDB. A2 SDB A1 that are my first hard disk size and its drive, and this is my recently created drive SDB 1 and SDB 5. Now I will permanent mount this drive by Vim editor. Now I'm going to Vim editor, Vim space slash dev, etc slash fstab, then press enter. This is our Vim editor. From here we'll create permanent mount. To write this editor, we'll from keyboard we'll press O, and now we'll write that we need. Now I'm showing it here. Slash dev 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 slash sdb1, and then press tab from keyboard, and here the path of this drive, that is slash mount mount 1, then press tab from keyboard, and then the file type ext4, then press tab again from keyboard, and we'll write defaults defaults defaults, then press tab again 0 space 0, then press enter. One mount one has been created. This is permanent mount. Again we'll write another for another drive slash dev slash sdb1, then press tab slash the location mount 2, tab ext4, the file type, and then press tab, and then here write defaults, then again press tab and 0 space 0. Yeah, our permanent has been created. Now we'll go back our bash from here. For this we must have to save this by doing something. Press ESC from keyboard and then shift clone, and then press X exclamatory mark, and then enter. It has been saved. Now we'll update our mount point. To update, write mount mount hyphen A. Yeah. Again, now we'll see our drives. To see drives, df hyphen h. Sorry, df space hyphen h. Press enter. our mount has been created. Permanent mount also has been created. If we reboot our machine, we also get this. Now I'm rebooting my machine. For this right reboot, REBOOT reboot. Then press enter. It has been rebooting, viewers. You will not take long time. Sometimes back. My machine is starting. I'm coming back. I'm logging in here. Now I see that I've created mount point, that I've created partition. That's our in my machine. Now I'm going to terminal and write df -h, enter. Yes, you can see that my mounted space sdb1 and sdb, sorry, here only we can see sdb1, as I think sdb5 has not been created correctly. We have a wrong. Now I'm going to again beam editor, bim space / etc / f step, then center. We have one wrong. Now I'm solving it. This is not 1, it will be 5. Okay. By saving it, I'll go back again bash. This is my bash. Now again I'll update the mount. For update mount, write mount mount space / a. Okay, it has been updated, and now I'll see the mounted partitions, mounted hard disk. For this, write df -h. This is my newly created, my newly mounted sdb5 sdb1. And this has come from my cache. If I again reboot, I'll not get this, only I will get these two, SDB1 and SDB5. Okay, viewers. This is the way of creating partition and creating mount point, and also it is the way of creating file type. Obviously, we need to give a file type. If I didn't give a file type, I can't create mount point, because this is the most necessary things to create a mount point, the file type. You should give a file type and then you create mount point. Now I'm seeing, I'll show you that my created partitions space. For this, I'm going to computer. Double click on file system and then mount one. If you will not get lost plus found, you will think that your mounted has not been created successfully. And after successfully mount one created, we will show this folder, and if you double click on here, this is our free space, this is our mounted folder, partitioned folder. Again, the second is mount 2. Yeah, you also able to see that this folder. Okay, viewers, that's all about partitioning our hard disk in our Linux machine. I will come back again in another in another tutorial to bring another things of our Linux server. Till then, okay, bye bye.